one of the most prolific scorers of his era. Carmelo Anthony has been a model of consistency. For 16 straight seasons, he averaged at least 21 points per game and won the scoring title in 2013. He currently ranks 9th all-time on the NBA's career scoring list.
Carmelo looking to become number 9 all-time. He's got it!
He's just a professional scorer.
The thing about Carmelo Anthony is that you always have a chance to win. And there are guys who get their 20 points and kind of shy away from the lights when they get bright. And then there are guys that when the light gets brighter, they're like a moth and they go straight to it. And that's Carmelo Anthony. One of the most ferocious first steps of any player I've ever played against in my 14 years. His tenacity to want to help his team win. Attention to detail and skill set. I think when he is done playing basketball, people realize how good he really was or really is, and just an absolute animal and competitor.
For a long period of time, he was the most difficult for me to defend of all of them. Like, you know, like his game was nasty. He could get nasty and bully ball you and bang you down in the block. But like, if he had that 17 footer face up going, it was over. It's game over. If he's not even a three, but I'm talking about if he was able to post up in that mid post and turn and get into his, and he had that jumper working that night, it's nothing you can do. I can finally remember many nights, you know, from Denver Melo to New York Melo to him being an absolute nightmare.
Anthony now on the drive. Oh, finish from Anthony.
The first time I see Melo play, we're in New York. We're playing in this same tournament in college. I'm at Marquette. Melo is at Syracuse. And I've never, like, I heard about LeBron, but I didn't hear about Carmelo until leading up until, like, that season in college. And that was my second year playing, and you know, I'm thinking I'm one of the best players in college, and I hear about this kid who's supposed to be the best player in college, and I'm like, let me check him out. And he had 30 and 10, and it was light. It was effortless, and I was like, oh. And in New York, in Madison Square Garden, we were playing in the same tournament, and I was like, oh, he's the truth.
Glad to see his journey back, and because he deserved his own ending, right, to write his own script. I watched more Portland games that year than any other team, just for Melo, and he's one of the best players I ever played with. I remember a story. It wasn't the first time, but it was a mutual respect thing, and I was with the Knicks. I did something in the game. I did like a crossover or something. And Melo, there was a foul call, and the ball came to him. He did a move, too. I was like, yeah, I got the handle, too. We both start cracking up laughing because, obviously, he's known for scoring, but he's not necessarily known for his handle, and he showed me one of his DC moves, so.
Carmelo Anthony! A little vintage Melo. Anthony for three. Bang! That one goes down, and the game is tied. Anthony for three. Puts it in! Next by one!
The big bucket. That's what I call Melo, man. Like, what Melo's been able to do over his entire career, it's been phenomenal. Like, it's just a credit to his work ethic. He's an NCAA champion. He's a gold medalist. I think it's 4, maybe even 5 times. Like, who's done that? Like, he's done some things in his career individually that not a lot of people have done on the planet Earth. And to watch him early on in his career, ISO guys, he's one of the best isolation players that I've ever seen. The jab, jumper, mid-range, unstoppable. The hang, dribble, pull-up, unstoppable. And he can post you up.
Rebound, Millsap. With Gallup.
Oh, pass,
slick pass.
Yes.
Melo! Oh, wow!
Now that was spectacular.
Carmelo, born scorer, natural scorer. A guy has endured a lot from the media, but never changed. A guy that I would say at times, you know, people tried to define him, and they were wrong, and he never listened. And a guy, I think, when we look back, you know, 20 years from now, we'll say, all of us around the game will say, we didn't appreciate Carmelo Anthony enough. I mean, one of the greats will go down as a Hall of Famer easily, but I think one of those guys, you started talking about the small forward position, will be up there easily as one of the greats to ever play that position.
3D, it is flat out disrespectful to think Carmelo Anthony is anything but one of the greatest and most dynamic scorers this game has ever seen.
Yeah, Jared, I think this generation is starting to appreciate it more now. I think they like to say there's levels to it. Well, Carmelo Anthony definitely had levels to scoring the basketball. Coming out of high school, going at Syracuse, he was a catch-and-shoot guy. Then when he got to Denver, he proved to everyone he could put the ball on the floor, he could be in mid-range, he can shoot the three. And they like to say, a walking bucket. Carmelo Anthony, consistently from high school to college and throughout his whole NBA career, was a walking bucket.
Yeah, and I think people forget he led Denver to the Western Conference Finals. He was the leader on that Knick team for so long. And then his career took a turn in that he became a role player and one of the best at what he's doing.
I'm so glad you said that, because people have to understand, when we use that word role, don't use it too lightly unless you understand what that really means. Carmelo's role most of his career was a 20, 25, 28, 30-point scorer. Then you have to change a little bit. But now the numbers come down, but you're still the same person where you have to get buckets, playing out of the double team. How many guys can say most of their career, every night, there was a double team coming to you, trying to slow you down, and you were still getting 26, 28 points a night, knowing that you had to get to the paint, get to the free throw line, late game situation, the ball's in your hand, go score one for your team.
And when it came to the world stage, where Carmelo was surrounded with the best of the best talent for USA basketball, he more times than not was the go-to guy getting the ball when it counted most.
Jared, people don't understand, when you're playing with the best, sometimes you have to check your ego. And I think that's when we really fell in love with Carmelo on a different level as far as playing the game of basketball. Because in Olympic basketball, playing in front of the whole world, he proved he could take his role differently, still score, play a little defense, rebound the basketball, but when in doubt, get USA a bucket.
Gets it to Anthony. Five on the shot clock. Anthony, one dribble. That's a three. It's good! Carmelo Anthony from way downtown. He's got 40.
Man, he was just one of my favorite guys to play against. You know, to play against one of your brothers. The things you can talk about on the court, the trash talk that you can that you guys have, it's just different. You know what I mean? We always appreciate the fact that Melo took us to Madison Square Garden. Like, our matchups versus Melo, Bron and Melo, Madison Square Garden. D-Wade, Melo, Madison Square Garden. You appreciate that because that set the stage for these amazing moments that in 20 years will still be talked about from all these Hall of Famers playing against each other and being friends.